My name is Tony Thomas. I, on August 3rd, 2008, just 6 days shy of my 50th birthday, I suffered a ruptured AAA. There were no warnings, nothing to indicate there was anything wrong. In fact, I woke up that day, I felt great. I was on the porch reading the newspaper, and I suddenly felt what I called a gurgle, many call it a flutter, on my right side near my back. And my daughter called for an ambulance. And the ambulance, obviously they came, got me to the hospital on time. Fortunately, we got through the surgery, as the surgeon said later, textbook. So the surgery went fine. I never heard of it, what a AAA was. I don't have much memory. I know I was looking at some screenings, these lifeline type screenings, and was considering going just a month or two prior to my rupture. So I know I'd been reading about it, but it just didn't stick home. I was more worried about carotid arteries or PADs, more to do with my heart because of my family history. In fact, I had first thought I had a stomach ailment because of the word abdominal. And it took me quite some time to figure out what exactly happened to me. And once I did, of course, it was shocking. Just the numbers were even more shocking. To think that 90% of the people that have this, they don't survive, they die. And to think that I was one of 10%, that was quite scary. I found out about Find the Answers campaign, going online. I always periodically research, looking into AAAs and what's going on with them, and saw that Kmarts were having free screenings. And went on the Kmart site, was looking into that. And of course, there was a link to the Find the Answers website, which I went on to. And I read some of the stories, I looked at some of the videos on there, was obviously intrigued by them because there were a couple of survivors. People had some great stories to tell about their experiences with AAA. And I decided to share my story. Just grateful to know that there is an organization out there that sees the potential for survival here. And to think that 95% of the people that died from this, 15,000, could live. And it's a needless death. It doesn't have to happen. And if people only were aware of what this disease really is and the potential of death that's tagged along with it, they might understand the seriousness of getting screened. And if I'd have trusted my instincts prior to what happened to me, prior to my rupture, I would not have gone through what I went through. And more important, my family wouldn't have gone through it. And that's the advantage to all of the people out there today, is that you have that opportunity, you have that chance that I didn't take, that I didn't give myself. And by spending 15 minutes getting such a non-invasive screening, an ultrasound of all things, to save your life, that's a blessing. That is truly a blessing.